Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Pandu. Today in this video we will discuss about welding imperfection and its preventing methods. Friends, the first imperfection is surface irregularity, and this is uneven weld bit ripples. In surface irregularity there are several types of weld imperfection, and one of them is uneven weld bit ripples, and it is described as abrupt changes in the profile of weld bit ripples. Here you can see this is the abrupt changes, and here you can see this is the imperfection, and its main causes are too low or too high welding amperage or voltage, and inappropriate welding electrode manipulation, and too much moisture in coating or fluxes, and too much flux burden height. So these are the main causes, and to prevent this we need to make some preventive measures, and one of them is to use the proper welding amperage or voltages, and second one is manipulate the electrode at appropriate speed, and redry the coating and fluxes, and use proper flux burden height. Friends, then we have excessive weld reinforcement, which is also defect because sometimes welding which is more than the required is kind of imperfection, and it is described as a face or a root reinforcement that has larger height than that specified. Here you can see the height is more than what is needed, then it's an imperfection. And here you can see the main causes are too slow electrode manipulation and too much root opening. Here you can see it's a narrow viewing width. Here you can see the viewing width is less. Then also it's may create a problem, and then you need a appropriate welding bridge. If it is more than the appropriate, then also wide weaving width is also one of the main root cause, and too much welding amperage is also one of the main causes for this kind of defect. Then to prevent this kind of imperfection, we need to manipulate the electrode at appropriate speed and adjust the root opening to the appropriate level, and use appropriate welding amperage and control the electrode displacement as required. Then we have concave fillet weld or convex fillet weld. Fillet weld that has excessive convexity or convexity is also one of the defect. Here you can see a good fillet weld is like this, and then we have concave fillet weld here, and then we have convex fillet weld here, which is not good, and it is kind of imperfection compared to good fillet weld. And the main causes are too fast electrode manipulation using too high welding amperage for concave fillet weld, and too low welding amperage or too slow electrode manipulation for convex fillet weld. Electrode travel angle is inappropriate. Then we need to make some preventive actions measures, like use appropriate welding amperage and electrode manipulation speeds with an appropriate travel angle. Friends, here if you are not subscribed to Engineering Pandu, please subscribe to Engineering Pandu. We will keep on uploading for you good fundamental videos. Friends, then we have uneven leg fillet weld. A fillet weld that has uneven legs, the upper leg is often smaller than the lower leg. Here you can see the uneven fillet weld in horizontal position. Here you can see an even leg fillet weld in horizontal position. The main causes are electrode work angle is inappropriate. Here you can see the angle of electrode must be appropriate. If it is not proper, then if it is more than required, here you can see, then it causes the uneven leg fillet weld. The preventive measures we can take is use appropriate electrode work angle as shown here in the figure. then we have undercut groove that is gouged in the base metal adjacent to the weld or weld root and is left unfilled by the weld metal. Here you can see this is unfilled and this is the undercut. Here also you can see this is the undercut. And the main causes are too high welding amperage, too fast electrode manipulation, too long arc weld or too high arc voltage, electrode travel and work angles are inappropriate. The wire tracking is too close to the groove face. And to prevent this, we can use appropriate welding amperages or electrodes manipulation speeds which with an appropriate arc length. Friends, then we have overlap and here you can see the protrusion of a weld metal beyond the weld toe or weld root is here. You can see this is the overlap and the main causes are too slow welding amperage, too slow electrode manipulation, too short arc weld, arc length or too low arc voltage and electrode travel and work angles are inappropriate. Here also you can see the fillet weld in horizontal position with the overlap. And to prevent this, use appropriate welding amperages, manipulation speeds, arc length, arc voltages and electrode travel and work angles. Friends, here we can see in almost all the cases the main causes are amperages and improper angle or manipulation, and to prevent that we need to use proper amperage. Then we have underfill and here you can see the bottom position. We have underfill. Here you can see the different positions and the main causes are too slow root opening, groove angle and too much root face and too low amperages or too long arc, inappropriate electrode manipulation. And to prevent this, adjust the root opening, groove angle and root face and use appropriate welding amperages and keep the arc length short. Use the suitable electrode manipulation as shown in the above drawing. Then we have porosity, it's we call pit also, and the cavity type discontinuities formed by the gas entrapment during the solidification of weld metal. Here you can see the different porosities here and the main causes are rust, oil paint or moisture on the joint fusion phases and high sulfur content of the base metal, moisture in the coating or fluxes or sealing gases, too little sealing gas or flux burden height, too much welding amperage, arc length or arc voltage. Then to prevent this, we need clean the joint fusion phases, re-dry coating and fluxes and use suitable sealing gases, use proper amount of sealing gas and flux burden height, and then use windscreens and use appropriate welding amperages, arc length and voltages. Then there is another kind of porosity that is known as blowhole. And cavity type discontinuities formed by gas entrapment during the solidification of a weld metal. Here you can see there are different kinds of blowholes here, and the main causes are also the same. It's because of rust, oil, paint, or moisture on the joint fusion phases and high sulfur content of a base measure, moisture in the coating, fluxes or sealing gases, too little sealing gas or flux burden height, too much welding amperage, arc length and strong wind. And to prevent this, we need to clean the joint fusion phases and re-dry the coating and fluxes and use suitable sealing gases, use proper amount of sealing gas and flux burden height, use a windscreen, use appropriate welding amperages, arc length and arc voltages. Here also you can see some of the root causes and preventive methods are same. Then we have slag inclusions and non-metallic solid materials entrapped in the weld metals or between the weld metal and base metal that is known as slag inclusion. Here you can see this is the slag inclusion. Here in X-ray report you can see the slag inclusion inside the weld, and the main causes are too low welding amperages, too much arc length, too much weaving width or too narrow groove slag that remains on the preceding layer, inclined weld axis in the horizontal by positioning. So to prevent this, use appropriate welding parameters and groove angles and remove slag of the preceding layer completely. Before doing the next weld, you need to remove the slag of preceding layer. Then keep the weld axis horizontal by positioning. Then we have incomplete fusion, a weld discontinuity in which fusion did not occur between the weld metal and joint fusion phases or between the adjoining weld bead. here you can see the X-ray report, and here you can see this is the incomplete fusion, and this is because of low welding amperages, too fast or slow electrode, too much little arc or arc voltages, too narrow welding groove. And to prevent this, use appropriate welding parameters and groove angles. Then we have incomplete joint penetration. Here you can see the middle one is the incomplete joint penetration, and the joint penetration that is unintentionally less than the thickness of the weld joint, and the main causes are too narrow welding groove, too low welding amperage, too much arc length or arc voltage, too fast or too slow electrode manipulation. And to prevent this, use appropriate groove configuration, use appropriate welding amperages, arc length and electrode manipulations. Then we have excessive melt through a hole through the weld metal usually occurs in the root pass. Here you can see the excessive melt through, and the main causes are too much root opening, too high welding amperages. And to prevent this, use appropriate root opening and weld amperages. Then we have cold crack. A crack that develops after solidification of weld metal is completed at temperatures lower than approximately 200 degrees centigrade. And here you can see the root crack. This is the root crack, and here also you can see the crack. And the main causes are diffusible hydrogen in the weld and retard structure of the weld, restraint stresses in the welds, and preventive measures are retry coating and fluxes and preheat base metals. Then we have hot crack. Here a crack that develops during the solidification of weld metals that is known as hot crack, and here you can see this is the crack. These are the cracks which are developed during the solidification of weld metal, and the main causes are too high amperages, too narrow welding grooves, too much sulfur content of the base metal. And to prevent this metal, hot crack, we need to some take preventive measures like use proper welding amperages and crater treatment, use appropriate groove angle, inspect the sulfur segregation of the welding groove before the welding. So friends, these are the few of the welding imperfection that are described. Those are described in general. And hope you will like this video. Thank you very much and happy learning.